Okay, so we've got wires on both sides there, and both sides there. That's good. So pick up from both sides. That crappy old decoder in there. Has to go. Getting back to the rails. That one can go with the brother over there. Much better decoder. Even though this is old too, TCST1, it's basically a clone of the DH121. Or 120, 121, same thing. These are good old basic Digitrax decoder, DH121, there we go. So it's basically a clone of that. Or 128 speed steps. This old piece of junk here was 14 steps only, which meant that I had to put the Digitrax into a special mode in order to get it to do anything at all. I had basically put the whole layout into 14 step if I wanted to use this locomotive or the other one that had that other decoder in it. That just ain't happening. So now then, do I want to use this one or do I want to wait for the one that's coming from China? Pause to think about it. Alright, that was a jump cut. So, let's decide what to do with this. I think I will use this TCST1 decoder. It's overkill for this because this locomotive is just going to be motor. I'm not going to hook up all of the functions. I'm not going to put lights on it. Because this one is just going to go in and out of a hidden track. Because my layout is CN based. CP is just going to provide some interchange from a track that disappears. So he's only going to poke up for a few seconds and then disappear. So I'm only going to need the four wires, track, which is black and red, and motor, which is orange and, what does that call itself, orange and gray, sure it's gray. So these other guys, blue, white, and yellow, are the blue's the lighting common, or the function common. The white and yellow are the forward and reverse LEDs, and these two guys out here, which it calls green and violet, sure, I'll take your word for it, those are for extra functions. So that's way more than I need for this, so I'll just chop those guys off. Not too short enough that I can use them again, but they won't get in the way. This guy's going to sit right on this little bridge that I made a long time ago. So I'll cut those wires down so that they just sort of end somewhere up on top of the motor. I'll heat shrink them all off. And they won't cause any problems. Save those wires for later. Yes, I'm that guy that saves random little bits of wires. Okay. Box of heat shrink. What do I have that's super tiny? Actually, probably just that black one that I already hit out there. Yeah, I don't have anything smaller anyway. Okay, so we'll use this one, which is 2 millimeter according to that. Okay. suppose I strictly don't have to do this. How many did I cut off there? 3, 5, 4. Well, it's just good practice. Also, I'm going to pull that off there. And I won't have to worry about harming it. Now then, let's find a lighter that's got some juice in it. This will be boring. So there's those guys shrinked off, so they're not going to short out or anything. But I can, if I ever decide to upgrade this, I can decide to use them later. Okay. Now then, from here, I could strip that back, cut off the old shrink that I had in with the old decoder, but I'm not going to because I'm going to be lazy. Just there. That out to about there. The black wire about the same. And where's the two motor wires actually? Got them about the same too, maybe a bit longer. Quick strip. Oh, what wires? Too fine for my automotive stripper. It goes down to 22. Okay. Risky mode. My sponge. Oh. I'm still figuring out this video thing. Tinning the wires so they've got a bit of solder on them. They go to connect them to the other wire. Deblob that. Anyway, that's that side. Now then, I used to have a better pair of wire strippers, but let's see if I can do this any less horribly. Okay, now then, where'd that go? Got some more wee bits of heat shrink. I ought to tin those guys first. Yes, I don't have a soldering iron holder. I'm just dangling it down by my knee here from the vise. Recommended? Oh, no. I haven't burned myself doing it yet, but... always a first time for everything. Now then, red wire, piece of shrink on it. So now that I've got these both pre-tinned, I can just do that, and there it is. So let it shrink up. I don't really want fire in that close to this. I'll just do it slow and gently. And these soldering irons, another thing that's old is the hills. Doesn't even say what its wattage is anymore. Oh, actually, no, this says in there. It's a 25-watt Weller. Decent soldering iron. Good brand. Yet another thing that I've had since the beginning of time. So, that was the red wire, which is track pickup. Black wire is the other track pickup. Let's see if I can do this without having to resort to... Get in there, you. Resort to getting the helping hands in there because it's annoying. Ah! Then again, so is this. I wonder if I can get fire in there without causing problems. That's not bad. Okay. And then the orange and gray wires. Back on. Now in. Make sure that stays in place. I keep doing this off camera, don't I? Tower can still turn, it's not going to bind. Okay. So, brand new decoder, it's going to be address 3. So let's put it up on the programming track and see if it works. Okay, here it is on the programming track. So let's see what happens. Yay! Uh-oh. Okay, so we have life. The wheels are a little cruddy, but we've got life. That's good. So, wheel cleaning. Bit of paper towel. Alcohol, the non-drinking kind, unless you're made out of money. Put that under one set of wheels. The pickup's still going to be happening from the other. This set of wheels. This one is going to spin. Okay, now that we know that it works, we'll add a little bit of weight to it so it's got some traction. These guys are self-adhesive tire weights. They come in nice regular sizes. These are all quarter ounce. This one's half ounce. I've got a few others. Some of the quarter ounce ones have snipped into eighth ounce, and there's an adhesive on the back and then the tape protecting on it. So I'm thinking that some of these quarter ounce ones that are separated, yeah, should fit just on top of the gear tower, and I think that that gives me clearance above. So there's another one that's a full quarter ounce. So, kind of like that. That'll give me some extra weight in there. And I think I can probably get away with putting a few up in the top of the cab there. Kind of lined up like that in the cab. There's a couple of them like that. I don't think they'll be visible from a normal viewing angle. No, you might be able to see them from there. Maybe I'll paint them black. But that would give us I could probably fit an extra ounce on there to give this guy much better traction, because right now he doesn't weigh very much. So all there is to this. Peel that backing off there without stabbing myself. Stick her down. So these, I got them from a guy who works in a tire shop. He sold them to me for dirt cheap. I can't remember what it was because it was a long time ago. But they are for mag wheels and aluminum wheels where you can't crimp on the normal type of weights. What do we got in here? Maybe a couple of quarters. So this adhesive is designed to stick onto wheel rims at highway speed, so I doubt very much it's going to be falling off my locomotive anytime soon. Where my tweezers go. And yes, it is actual real lead, which means if you're concerned about poisoning yourself, I would recommend, you know, not licking your fingers after you've done this. Probably wash them first. A clever person would have painted those first. Okay, into the shadows. Nice. Let's see now. Get some light in there. You see that through there? You can't see it through the side. It's up above, but you can see it through the front and the back. So I'll probably get down in there with a paintbrush and just put some flat black on it. But in the meantime, just tuck all these wires in here, get them out of the way of the motor shafts, because that would be bad. I'll tuck them back and I'll put the cover on and I'll come back and give her another test run. Here's the entire point of that locomotive. This is its only job. To appear occasionally out of the CP interchange track, drop off a car where CN can get it. Pick up whatever CN's dropped off for, if we're sending to CP. And take it out towards wherever CP services. Apparently I have to widen that a little bit. Okay, I have some landscaping to do over there, or foam curving. That tunnel's too narrow for a long car. But that's another project for another week.